Hey everybody, I'm Scott Meek with Diesel Training. I'm going to show you today how to use an amperage clamp. Now you're probably wondering, Scott, when am I going to need an amperage clamp? When should I take that out of my toolbox? Well, there's a couple different reasons. Reason number one, remember, your multimeter has a fuse that has a maximum rating to protect your multimeter. Now in this particular multimeter, it's a 20 amp rating. And what that means is, if I'm using my multimeter to measure amperage and I exceed a 20 amp draw, then the fuse inside that meter will blow. Number two, accessibility, ease of use. In other words, instead of having to break the circuit and put your multimeter in series with that circuit to detect your amperage draw, all we have to do is take our amp clamp, install it, and go around the wire that we want to measure. So today, we're going to show you how to do that. Now, when it comes to using an amp clamp, you're probably wondering, how exactly can I measure current flow with an amp clamp, or how does that amp clamp work? Well, something you have to be aware of in an electrical circuit is anytime current moves through a wire, a magnetic field is created 90 degrees of that circuit. So basically what that means is, if I have a small amount of amperage, I'll have a small magnetic field. In other words, if I'm moving 1 amp of current, I'll have a very small magnetic field present. But the more current I draw, the larger the magnetic field. So say 1,000 amps, I'm going to have a much larger magnetic field. And this particular tool actually measures that magnetic field and then converts it into an amperage measurement for you to read with your multimeter. Again, you got to understand that there's a difference, because how we set up our meter is actually drastically different using an amp clamp than in the video I previously showed you with using your leads. Now, when we talk about, you know, magnetic fields or electromagnetism, that actually brings me to another point that, if you check out our next tech tip video, we'll cover that, talking about relays. Now that we have an idea of how this amp clamp works, before I take the time to connect it to my multimeter and show you how to set it up and take these measurements, there's one other thing I need to talk to you about, and that's polarity. Now, what is polarity? Polarity is the direction that electrons are moving within a circuit. Now, in our world, we're dealing with DC predominantly, or direct current. And with direct current, polarity moves in the same direction. So, for an example, in conventional theory, electron theory, those are two different things. In conventional theory, our electrons move from the positive side of the battery through our circuit and return to the negative side. Now, that's how most of us technicians were taught. Now, the electron theory is actually the opposite. It states that electrons move from the negative side of the battery through the circuit to the positive terminal. Now, don't overcomplicate that. What I want you to hear is that polarity is the direction of flow. We leave one side of the battery, we return to the other, okay? Now in AC, or alternating current, your polarity will actually change. It will go from positive to negative, and then the next second, negative to positive. Or obviously, depending on the type of circuit, maybe much faster. So why am I telling you this? The word circuit is actually circle, because our electron flow make a circle, they make a loop. And so what happens is, if you look at it this way, if our electrons are moving to our load, coming from our load, and then back to our battery, we are making a loop. So electrons are going, electrons are coming, they're going opposite directions. So that means that one magnetic field will be 90 degrees this direction, and on the return path, a magnetic field will be 90 degrees this direction. That's important, because when you're using an amp clamp, if I were to take my amp clamp and go around the positive and negative side of a circuit, it actually neutralizes the magnetic field. It counteracts each other. So what do you end up with? 0 amps. Now, that doesn't mean you have 0 amps. If your blower motor's working, then you obviously have amperage draw. It's just because you went around both sides of the circuit, the positive and the negative, so you've canceled the waves out. So the reason I tell you that is, when you're using your amp clamp, you need to go on either or. You need to either go on the positive side of the circuit or the negative side of the circuit, but not both at the same time. So now it's time to go ahead and grab our multimeter, our amp clamp, get them set up so we're ready to take our measurements. Now, real quick, before we do that, if you look at your amp clamp here, this particular model, you'll see that we have two options. We have a 200 amp and we have a 2000 amp on our DC setting. Now, on this particular circuit, we're not going to exceed 200 amps, so we would move to the 200 amp port. Now, secondly, if you look down here at the bottom, you're going to see that our maximum input is 2000 amps. That means we cannot exceed 2000 amps on our circuit. However, if you look underneath that, it says the output is 1 millivolt per amp. Now, basically what that means is I'm going to have to set up my multimeter in the DC millivolt setting because this amp clamp requires that. And once I do, I'll have a 1-to-1 ratio, which means on my multimeter in the millivolt setting, if I have 1 millivolt, that means I actually have 1 amp of current draw. So to set that up, what we'll need to do is take our digital multimeter. We're going to remove the leads from the voltage ports. That's where our amp clamp is going to go. Now remember, if you're measuring amperage with your multimeter leads, your common lead stays here, but you're going to move your positive lead to the port that supports that amperage value. But when you're using an amp clamp, that's not the case. We're going to take our leads from our amp clamp, we're going to take the positive lead, and we're going to go to the voltage port. Okay? I know that's a little odd, but again, that's how it has to be set up. Then we're going to take our negative lead or our common lead and put it in the common port. Once we do that, we're going to take our multimeter and set it to DC millivolts. Now, with our amp clamp in the on position, now we need to zero this value out. If we look now, you'll see that we have 116 millivolts. So by pressing the zero feature, now my multimeter should be zeroed out and ready to measure amperage. So here we see 0.3 or 3/10. So just something to know is once you zero your meter, it won't always go to 0.0. Sometimes you may have 1/10 or 2/10. That's okay, just add that to your measurement. You may want to press the zero icon one more time and just see if it zeros out. In this case, it took us down to 1/10 of an amp, and that's perfectly acceptable. Yeah. All right, so let's go ahead and start taking an amperage measurement. And remember, when you're measuring amperage, in order to measure amperage, the circuit must be powered because remember, we're measuring current flow. So we're going to take our blower motor, we're going to turn it on the lowest speed, and then we're just going to take the jaws of the amp clamp and put it around our positive wire at the blower motor. So now you'll see I should have an amperage draw on low speed, which is currently 3.1 amps. Now remember, it says 3.1 MV, which is millivolt, but remember, it's a 1-to-1 ratio because that's how it must be set up. So this is actually 3 amps of current. Now, as I increase this blower speed, my amperage draw should increase as well. So now we're up to 5.7 amps, 7.9 amps, and then on max speed, we are 11.6 amps. So as you can see, as the demand increases, the amperage increases, and we're making that measurement using our multimeter and amp clamp. So now to refer back to a comment I made previously, that if you go around the positive and negative side, it'll cancel that magnetic field out. I want to show you what that looks like because again, if the blower's working, we have amperage draw, we have current flow. But if I go around the positive and negative at the same time, I'm canceling out that wave field, which is giving us essentially a zero value again because that field has been neutralized. All right, so one last thing that I want to make sure you're aware of is anytime you're using an amp clamp, it's very important to understand where in the circuit you're taking the measurement. Now, in this particular example, it's not really an issue because my entire HVAC assembly is working off this one single wire. Now, if you go into a fuse panel and you're checking an amperage measurement, let's say on one side of the fuse you have your power feed, which is one single wire, but on the other side of the fuse, maybe you have three wires coming off of that fuse. If you go around all three wires, then you're checking every component in that circuit, and it may be something else besides HVAC tied into that circuit. So the best thing to do is to go to the components that are causing the amperage draw value or maybe the component that's causing you the issue. And in this case, we went directly to the blower motor to see exactly what that blower motor was drawing while using an amperage clamp. Thank you for joining us today. We hope you found this tech tip helpful. We hope you feel a little more confident using your multimeter and your amp clamp. But don't forget to come back and join us for a future tech tip video on how relays function and how to troubleshoot them.